In Excel, there is no built-in function to sum values based on the color of cells. However, you can overcome this limitation by creating a custom formula using Visual Basic for applications. This can be particularly useful when you need to perform calculations on data that is color-coded. Consider a scenario where you have a dataset and you want to sum values based on their cell colors. To achieve this, you can write a VBA function. To use VBA for creating a custom function in Excel, ensure the Developer tab is visible on the Excel ribbon. To add the Developer tab, click on the File tab. Select Options. In the Excel Options dialog box, click on Customize ribbon. Under Main tabs, check the box next to Developer. Click OK to save the changes. To open Visual Basic Editor, click on the newly visible Developer tab. Click on the Visual Basic icon. In the VBA Editor, click on the Insert tab. Choose Module from the drop-down menu. I will paste the VBA code into the module. This VBA code defines a custom function named SumCellsByColor that takes two parameters. CellRange, a range of cells where the function will sum the values based on their background color. CellColor, a single cell that defines the target color for summing the values. Custom functions, also known as user-defined functions, allow you to extend Excel's built-in functions by creating your own. They are written in VBA and can be used in Excel formulas just like regular functions. Custom functions are particularly useful when you need to perform specialized calculations that aren't covered by the standard Excel functions. The function starts by declaring two variables, cell color value to store the color index of the target cell and running sum to accumulate the sum of values with the specified color. Cell color value is assigned the color index of the target cell's background color using cell color interior color index. The interior color index property is utilized to determine the color of a cell's background. The color index property returns a numeric value representing the color index of the cell's background. Each color in Excel has a unique index, allowing you to identify and compare colors. The function then iterates through each cell in the specified cell range using a for each loop. Inside the loop, it checks if the background color index of the current cell matches the target color. If there's a match, it adds the value of that cell to the running sum. After the loop completes, the function returns the calculated sum cells by color. You can use this custom function in a worksheet like any other Excel function. Let's use the macro to sum cells by color. We have sales data. Let's calculate the sum for all three colors. Write the sum cells by color function. For the first argument, select cell range to sum. It is sales column. Press F4 to lock the cells. For the second argument, select cell color. Drag and fill this formula down to each remaining color and the formula will automatically sum each of the cells that have specific background colors. Let's check the total sum of sales column and total sum of colors. We can confirm that it is the same. Let's check the sum of cells with light green background manually. This matches the value calculated by our formula. The formula is dynamic and would automatically update in case you make any changes to the dataset. In case the formula is not updating, press Ctrl plus Alt plus F9 to recalculate all formulas in Workbook. Since we have used a VBA code in the Workbook, it needs to be saved as a macro-enabled workbook with XLSM extension. To save a macro-enabled workbook, first, go to the File tab and click on the Save As option. After that, specify the location where you want to save your file. Next, from the Save As type, select Excel macro-enabled workbook. In the end, click OK to save the file. While Excel lacks a built-in function for summing cells based on color, an alternative method involves using filter based on the cell color and the subtotal function. This approach is handy when you want to perform calculations on a filtered subset of data, and the subtotal function is specifically designed for such scenarios. The subtotal function is designed to run a given calculation on a range of cells while ignoring cells that should not be included. It automatically ignores cells that have been filtered out. We have the same dataset. Write subtotal function. For the first argument, we need to choose the function. Choose sum function. It corresponds to number 9. For the second argument, select the sales column. To add filters to headers, navigate to the Home tab, find the Editing group, click on Sort and Filter, and select Filter. This will add filter icons to your header row. In the Sales header, click on the Filter icon. Choose the Filter by Color option from the drop-down menu. Click on the specific color based on which you want to filter the dataset. Once you've filtered the dataset by color, observe that the subtotal result dynamically adjusts. The subtotal function now calculates the sum of only those cells that are currently visible based on the chosen color. If you decide to filter by a different color within the dataset, the subtotal function will automatically adjust. It consistently provides the sum of cells corresponding to the selected color, adapting to changes in your filtering criteria. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button.